Welcome back, everybody, here to game number two of the Russian Dota 2 League, where RoX is going up against Team Dignitas in this best of three quarterfinal from the winner's bracket. It's our last quarterfinal to get through, and right now, if anything is like game number one, it could be over very, very quickly. Dignitas basically rolled over the top of game number one. How are they going to go with game number two? Well, that is something we get to find out right now. So, RoX, they will be over here on the Dire side. Dignitas over on the Radiant side. Already the first ban coming out here from Way Too Sexy is going to be that Nyx Assassin. We've seen him appear multiple times tonight and still effective as ever. He's still effective as ever. They try and nerf him, but he's still effective as ever. It's a real pain in the ass. Sometimes I get rid of him. I look forward to that day. But for now, he is still being played up. Wisp also again for the fifth time tonight. It's going to get banned here in the first two sections. So not going to get through and picked up or have a possibility of being picked up. Keep of the Light also going to get banned out, which means you see the Darkseer or the Mag. One of these two heroes will come through. And more than likely, RoX is trying to bait through. Yeah, they're going to bait through, if not one, two of these heroes. So Darkseer is a pickup here from Way Too Sexy, which means we'll see both the Mag and probably the Nakes coming out here from RoX. Now go with what is their strengths, and that's going to be team fight and strength. Obviously, strength. Yeah, that should be the pickups here from Biz. Unless he wants to try and do something a little bit more different. There's a Darkseer on the field, so maybe think going up with a Rubick in the early stage is not too bad. Mag and Lone Druid, so we go the full strength. And Way Too Sexy is now forced to pick up the Nakes. He has no other option. He must pick up the Nakes right now. If you combine up the Nakes with these two heroes and you get half decent support heroes, then this game is over. This game is fully over. But Way Too Sexy won't fall for that one. Or shouldn't fall for that one. Let's see. Gyro pickup. Decent damage. And Nature's Prophet. He takes out the Prophet instead. He picks up the Prophet instead. So, what is a potential on a split push right now, plus having a huge team fight? We go with a little bit weaker of a split pusher as far as like his own strength, but very, very strong in the fact of split pushing. And when Gyro and Darkseer, who are like team fight controllers, but if they get control at the very, very start, they are so screwed. 10 seconds. And Biz, his choice. They tried running the Nakes last time. And it really just did not work. Early tonight, too, another Nakes tried to run, but then all of a sudden Orchid came out and there was just nothing else from that. So Biz, does he still feel the confidence to go with the Nakes and then just pick up something like a Latrak and a Lion or a Chen? They've already got a lot of strength up their sleeves, so what if they just go down the line of the Chen? If they don't pick up the Nakes right now, Way Too Sexy will take it. We'll ban it out in the next three. 100% guaranteed. Unless he wants it himself. He does have first pick coming into the next set. Would force the Gyro in towards the middle lane, however, so Aoi wouldn't get to play that Gyro. It'll be a fogged Gyro for the mid solo then. But let's see, Biz. I'm going to make a choice, man. 35 seconds on the clock. Makes it very, very easy banning for Dignitas in the next section. Take out Chen. Take out Enchantress. Those two are guaranteed. Plus one. Plus one from that. But they can't make up their minds. Are they feeling the Mag is still going to have an easy enough time there in the middle lane if he's up against a Gyro? It's going to be a pretty rough lane, but it's doable. It's doable. As long as he finds the levels and gets the support from the support. Yeah. That just happened. Venno pick up here. This makes me wonder. It's not going to be a safe lane lone druid then. I know, it could still be anything. I'm still thinking about that combination with the lone druid with the orb plus the Venomancer on top of that. And their ability to control the lanes. And then Juggernaut also taken out. Yeah, they're looking at the Nakes to start with because they're worried about the three big melee men. And then they take out the Juggernaut as well because you had three melee. They can still go four melee and then add a healing ward on top of that. Venomancer helps with the pushing power, helps with the initiation at the very, very start. But the Gale, costs a lot of mana. Requires early clarities, which means you can't stack up on different heroes. You need to actually keep a fair chunk of that gold on the Venomancer at the very, very start. Bane gonna be the third ban out here by Roxkiss. So they're feeling there's still gonna be some level of control over BKB style heroes. Remaining. Or Nightmare would screw with them too much. Who would be that last one that they'd be fearful that a Bane would be picked up? Wait, with this lineup. Wait. No. I'm going bonkers thinking Ursa. I'm thinking level 1 Roshan is what's in my mind right now with this lineup. Because even if Team Dignitas did know about it, their level 1 team fight, it's not really that amazing. Not up against Bears, Venomancer, Mag. Especially if Mag is giving everybody the Empower bonus at level 1. I am wondering. But let's wait and see. 5 seconds remaining. Let's wait and see. SD is the next ban. So more controlling heroes against an aggressive tri-lane. With a level 1 Roshan, you can go a lot more aggressive. And I'm thinking Venomancer with his Gale. And then if you can get it up fast enough, early phase boots up on the Ursa. And then just one extra supporter on the bottom lane. Could be Rubick or... Oh, yeah, not anymore. Rubick being removed out. But just one more supporter. And with the double slow, if you get the orb plus the Venomancer Gale, then you can look like a hero like a Lashrac, but you want someone that can also give you a bonus in the early section of the game. You want someone that can actually help you bring down that Roshan if that's really what they're attempting. So now third pickup. Third ban out by Biz. He's taken out supports. What else is going to be really frustrating for him to play up against? He probably thought he was going to ban the Rubick as the third one if he wasn't going to take it himself. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. So Biz. Jakiro was the final one. Not played by a lot of teams, but we've already seen him featured tonight. And Warlock, we're going to go classic Dignitas. Warlock for the solo mid. That's Fog's hero, which means Aoi Gyro. Nature's Prophet on the long lane. No, Nature's Prophet in the jungle, which means Darkseer in the long lane. It's melee, so he should be okay. Until Venomancer starts harassing him. And that's what Roxkiss could do, too. Like, I'm talking about the aggressive tri-lanes and Roshans, and that's, like, the action-packed version of what could possibly happen out here from Roxkiss. But at the same time, you also look through the lineup and go, well, it could just be a defensive Venomancer, defensive Lone Druid on his lane, Mag in the middle lane, or any mage. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. No. Actually, he could still be solo top. Very, very unlikely. And Shadow Shaman, the last one. One of way too sexy's favorite heroes. So he'll take the Shadow Shaman. And Biz, he's hoping the anti-mage carry through will be enough. But there's a lot of disable that's going to hold him there. And the big team fight counter. Enchantress is a final one. We're going defensive. Dread onto the Lone Druid, solo on the Mag. And let's get ourselves into this game. Alright, so let's run through quickly through the dig. Oh, because we had the patch, it turned off my settings. Arrgh, I hated how it still does this. Please fix. So let's run through our lineup. So it will be Sneaking, actually, taking the mid-solo. It won't be Fogged on the Warlock, which means Universe takes up his role as the Darkseer. Fogged, supporting again as the Shadow Shaman. Dignitas are one of these teams where they might be unstable and very, very random with who plays what, but they keep switching it up. We had a support Fog last game, and then he turned into a semi-hero with farm. But in this case, he will definitely be a proper support. Gyro, he'll be up as the role as, he's the role. He's being played by Aoi, and that leaves our last one way too sexy as Nature's Prophet instead. And then through Roxkiss, no early attempt. Dread on the long lane as the lone druid. Solo for the solo mid, and that leaves our top lane, which is the supporters. Enchantress, which is played by Yol. Vanxor will be the Venomancer, and that leaves our last one, which is Biz, taking the high carry role as the Animage, and there is going to be very little to... Well, nothing that is going to be able to allow them to stop him from farming. Absolutely nothing. Universe is already just moving back and forth here, but he'll go himself inside the jungle. He might be thinking about heading towards the top lane, but, well, Nature's Prophet's built half for the top lane and half for the jungle. And Universe is built for top lane. We get a couple of iron... Actually, no, he's also built for the jungle. It's for an early Sol Ring build. Alright, so in the mid, first creep waves are always engaged, so, well, lock and mag, they say hello, instant fatal bonds. So hello, solo, take the extra damage. So it's all about, drop him down low, keep him away from the creep wave, but while he's away from the creep wave, like, it's just sneaking. He gets the last hits and just returns a lot of the damage. So solo already down to 2/3 of his life, hits the secondary shockwave just on the edge. But this lane should be, well, I won't say completely controlled by Warlock, but it definitely should be in Sneaking's favor, depending on the speed. And there you go again, Fatal Bonds. And Solo just has to take it, like a man. It's the only thing for him to do. There's no fallback and farm from range. Even gonna come range of the tower. Nice little bonus damage being returned to Solo. And he has one last hit away from having his bottle. And it's the bottle's already on the way for Warlock. But that's what Enchantress is here for. This is the way to stop a mid control. Is it the pool anymore? No. It's hatred towards geckos. And that's exactly what's going to happen right now. Y'all is only here for that reason. But then Flying Courier. Y'all. 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 Timing was horrible. He couldn't be more patient and wait around for the courier to come. And the flying courier came up just at the right time as well. So it's like Sneaking going to use the entire courier, entire bottle too, and then send it back. Not worrying about the 2-minute rune. Universal check out the top. It's not there. It's on the bottom. But the bear will come down. And it can swipe the invis at least. It's not going to be used because it doesn't work on bears. But at least see it. And he's going to let Fogged have it. Fogged is also up to level 3. Man, must be having some good pulling time to be level 3 already on a support. He's going to move himself in towards the middle lane. So see if he can team up here with Warlock. Have to wait another 16 seconds before this open wounds will come. The Fetal Bonds will come off cooldown. Or maybe just go now. Shock. Hold him. And that was a lot of damage coming the way of Solo. He tried to skewer himself away. Because the Fetal Bonds was triggered and then the 2 points up in Aether Shock returned all the damage from all the creeps were there, which basically disintegrated in the shock. Well, it was a very simple rotation. They left the rune, the bear didn't take it. And that meant then, first blood, Dignitas, middle lane. Well, Aoi on the bottom lane, how's he looking? 14 for 2 up against a lone druid, who's 5 for nil. Could be worse. Oh, he's gonna resummon him for bear. Okay, it's worse for Dreb. It's a lot worse for Dreb. And then up towards our top lane, Universe. 10 for nil, not too bad for an off-laning Darkseer who hasn't really left this lane. Up against a 22 for 5 Animage. So, still, Animage can be happy. Ring of Health now. Yep. Boots. Yep. Buys them both. Still having to deal with the Iron Shell damage, but with now with this Ring of Health, he won't care too much about it. And with a Venomancer, who, Ring of Health plus the Enchantress Sata. So, got the Regeneration Order on top of this. And the Hellbear Smasher. They'll force the tier 1 tower. Blink down, already finding Universe. Quick surge away. And got nothing else that will stop him. Venom wasn't going to catch up in time to get at least a Gale off. And this Iron Shell has pulled the creep aggro down, so now they're stuck between the tier 1 and the tier 2 tower. Dignitas have the choice to TP and support this. Way too safe, he could just TP in normally. So they're going to leave the Hellbear to tank up the tier 1 tower. The Hellbear gets to stay alive, the aggro taken by the creep wave. And Universe, too close. Surge though, and then Gale means nothing. He'll tick down a little bit. But it is tier 1 tower gone. We saw this also in the last game. It doesn't mean it's a bad thing when you lose a tier 1 tower this early on. It's a bad thing if you lose the tier 2 tower and the momentum can carry through to the tier 3 tower. Then it's a bad thing. Shackles, bear's dead. Aoi will open up on it with the shock too. Drake cops a little bit of flak damage, but that means he's, again, he's forced to resummon and keep that bear on cooldown. And Warlock at his level 6. Man, it's almost like he wants Solo to come at him. If he drops the ulti now, he's got him. Yep. Oh! Oh, Solo! He knew it! He knew it! I'm waiting for the smiley face. I'm waiting for the tongue and or cheek. He managed to bait out the ultimate from sneaking. Sneaking's gonna be pissed off about that. Skewered away the second he saw the animation. So he'll just use his golem to farm up the ancients now. Oh, man. And then the bottle arrives, the Solo's back up to full again. And now gank time too. Double Centaur coming out from Enchantress. Sending in the one with the longest time first. And, oh, actually, this can be a decent kill. Killing that guy off. Yeah, that's 100 easy gold. And Dread. There's a smile coming out from him on that bottom lane. What happened with that? Did he lose his bear again? Did he lose his bear? He lost his bear again. He's got no bear. He gets a break and gets an invis rune. It looks like they threw everything into killing that bear. And rightly so. And now Prophet TP's in and snipes the invis. Dread was holding it for Solo. And there was an observer wall there. He knew exactly what he was going into then. Man, RoxKiss are not getting a break. They cannot catch a break. And now bottom lane will push. Army of Trees has created this. No bear to stop this. It's a level 4 Dread. He'll pull the aggro back. And there's more support coming in from the Venomancer. But with Fogged, Hex, now possible Shackle, cooldown. Ah, no one's still there. Creep Reef doesn't even get attacked by that. They gotta whittle down this tower though. Something that Aoi can't do any more of, because Fortification stops that one. Biz, initiating again on Universe, just forces a quick surge away. He's got Sol Ring, he doesn't really care about using too much mana here. Well, Fogged. See, I'm used to it. I'm so used to it. Sneaking. The stand-in. Soloing up in the middle lane. And Dread's still gonna chill here on the bot. Yol. So he's up here on the top lane. Had to pick up a weaker Hellbear. Probably just picked it up because there's nothing else left for him. And then blink down Universe. Quick search away again. Beers might have ultimate, but it's not enough to kill off the Darkseer. He's got too much life on him. But it does mean this tier 2 tower is going to be pressured a little bit more at the same time. Damn, that's a long shackle. It is crazy just how long that shackle can be. It's a level 1. That's meant to be the range of the shackle. It's meant to be the range, but if you cast it and they keep walking, it gets a little bit longer. Because it's the starting cut. It's the animation time. Oop, trouble. This time Sneaking hits his ultimate, this time on Solo, and then Prophet ensures the kill. But then, more help coming in. Quick Illusion Rune, Sneaking trying to bottle up, and well, wait to see, he cannot TP himself out of that one. And Sneaking, man, what are you doing? You should have just run and TP'd, he's trying to fight Peters. Actually, oh man, he can fight Peters! He's healing himself up while using his golem perfectly to do that damage to an anti-mage who is obviously, yeah, like, Pomeran Shield, that's all he's really got. Hey, you get yourself in the danger zone. Solo. RP may be on cooldown, and then Prophet comes in. Three levels up in the trees, and they got themselves a golem. What more do you need? Probably not to have Venomancer Wards being a pain in the ass. Level 3 up on those things as well, and the shockwave damage. Trying to deny their sneaking. Unsuccessful, though. Beer's still farming up there on that top lane. Now with enough cash for both the damage items, this requires a Void Stone, and yep, there you go, Broadsword Claymore. Puts him on the Courier, flies him down. He wants that Battle Fury up and running. And Dignitas, they need more map control. They need a lot more map control, and they need it on the top lane too. They haven't taken a single tier 1 tower, and they've lost their own tier 1 tower. Sure, these towers are injured, but they haven't taken them. Now he's trying to get rid of it. Flat Cannon up a little bit more. Dread might be completely shut down here on the bottom lane. He's 15 for 1. The Venomancer almost has more farm than he does. But for now,
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
What? Why did he send it up with just one of them? It's a waste. Oh, fogged. He's got him. He's got him. He's got him. Heck no! Fogged! What were you doing? Throw down these wards! Get those wards! He's trying to hold him there, but he's taking up the tower a little bit too much. Ah, he's gone. When I say tower, he's taking up the wards. There goes Solo. Two heroes in the sidelines. And Shadow Shaman held his mass serpent wards. He could have just come in for the shock and kill a flown druid. I don't... That is a high enough level shock. Is he level 4? Yeah, it's level 4 shock. 320 damage on a lone druid, who I'm pretty sure had like maybe 200. But he let him go. What a nice fogged. Probably wasn't really expecting that to be on a silver platter for him. Now TP to the top lane. So fogged will come and defend this. Quick shock if he needs to. We can also hex up Biz. There goes the shock, and Biz not happy with this. Only 1 point up from that spell shield right now, so resistance not amazing. And a minus as well comes out here from Way Too Sexy. So he played the gold battle. Solo. Death. Even if he skewers away right now, he's still going to die. The creeps were still basically tethered to him. The fatal of the bonds. The fatal bonds. And then Golem. Golem with catapult. You can try and stop this in the middle lane, but if you do, this is going to happen to you. Shackle, Prophet, TP's in. All he needs is vision. Sprout tries to give it to him, and Fog, there's your hex. Now Shackle. Shock. Okay, he says screw it. Darkseer comes in with an iron shell and just takes the last hit out. So tier 1 tower to go down in the mid. And they'll push the tier 2 tower now. And Universe right behind, and Mass Serpent Wars to go. They're forcing this time. Enchantress almost losing that troll, bring her in close. And then the rocket to fly. Not attacked fast enough. And fortification will be used here by Roxkiss. They really want to hold this tier 2 tower in the mid. Get the extra gold out from farming up these wards. Looks like between them all, they've got enough life points to deal with that. And then move back. Fog pings out the rune. Who was that one for? Well, who's running the bottle? Owie. It's just not cool, man. It's just not cool. That is not cricket. It's cooldown. No. Benno. No. He dies on the edge of it. Antivage and Solo will team up together to bring him down. Antivage and Solo. Yeah, back. Oh, yeah. The Iron Shell attack of the Invis. It is the worst thing he can have as a support. You don't know which way to run. And he's in Shadow Blade, so his movement speed is faster than yours. He'll come out of it and then do a big hit, which is what he did. And just drops the life points. Fogged trying to bring down this top tower. Up comes Anti-Mage and Fogged. Fogged. Aye. Way too sexy. Everybody's Fogged in this game. Battle Bonds. Yep. Ties beat his, no, business fate. The rest of the creep wave, and I'll damage him down a little bit. But he won't care too much about it. Oh well, then again. No treads. Only 720 life points. Maybe it is something to care about. Something to care about is the farm up on Dreb. And can build up the phase boots right now. He's got the items on him. Looks like the courier just delivered them in. So he'll bring the phase boots up on the bear. That's a 13-minute lone druid, and he's got basically, what, tranquils and phase boots. And a couple of branches for a 13-minute lone druid. He has got very, very little. What's his net worth? It's the fourth highest on the map. And two below him are the dire side, Enchantress and Venomancer. Shadow Shaman is the broker's hero on Dignitas, and he's walking around with extra sentry wards, braces, boots, wand. Got all this stuff coming his way. And Biz has taken a lot of it, but you see what he's taken? Like, for the almost 6k worth of net worth he has, he's got a Battle Fury. That's what he brings to his team. For all this cash they put into him, he gets a Battle Fury. And for a Gyro, Shadowblade phase boots, as well as having a Wraith Band. So he brings Initiation, he brings a large portion of damage, and that's what he brings to his team in these early levels where any mage has a couple of right clicks. He still relies heavily on a mag to set up properly for him, and that means he needs to have the RP. And the best best position for that is never really... You need a blink dagger for it. He's working his way towards it, but it comes with time. And time isn't really something they have a lot of. Not when Warlock is still farming up too, and now he is, yeah, 800. We tried to see an Aghanim Scepter ultimate earlier tonight, and it got to this point, and then all hell broke loose, and the Aghanim Scepter took about 15 minutes to 20 minutes to complete after that point, or something like that. And now I see Warlock at 868 gold away from having his Aghanim Scepter up and running. So maybe a time to go. Good to see sneaking being very, very nicely mannered about it. Just a reminder too, guys, that this is the last best of three matchup for tonight. But coming up tomorrow, we'll be doing the Tech Labs broadcast. So it is VP versus IC Cup. That is the first game, the first cab off the rank, starting at 7:15 tomorrow. 7:15 is the scheduled starting time. That is CET for the Russians. It's 2 hours ahead, so it's 9:15 is their starting time, hence it's so early for the rest of Europe. For Empire versus Na'Vi, that will start off at 8:15. So it's a best of one matchup for both these games until the grand final, which is a best of three. So that's what's coming up tomorrow. So it begins, we'll be broadcasting it out right on this live stream, so you don't have to go check any other live stream but this one. But you can do so. Shiva will be streaming, Starlight TV will be streaming as well. And you can see all those live streams listed up over from the joinDOTA live and upcoming tool. It's basically your TV guide to DOTA to know who is casting what and where. Also see what's coming up over next time. So we'll be starting that one up, and then at the same time, G1 League also running the qualifiers tomorrow. Actually, if we check out all of the events for tomorrow, I think there's actually a decent amount of events coming up tomorrow. 23rd's a busy day. Tech Labs, G1, SK doing their trophy fights again tomorrow. I believe they actually started off today with Boberg casting those ones. And then, yeah, WePlay is on tomorrow. Play for Dota, so it's the 4PL Cup. Its finals are on tomorrow night. Lot of action coming up for your Saturday of Dota. But meantime, we get ourselves back in to this event. The Russian Dota 2 League. So there goes Top Tower. Nature's Prophet will take that one. Prophet Ultimate also trying to help out the bottom lane. TP's down and tries to fight up against Red. Locks him in the trees. He's trying to convert into his ultimate form, but it's way too late. They get the kill there. In the meantime, in the mid, Fatal Bond solo. Oh, he's always TP'd out that one. The Fatal Bonds are still connecting, and they need a little bit more damage into solo. But they don't care. They're taking a tier 2 tower in the bottom lane. The Mass Open Wards are down by Fogged. And the rest of Rox, because they're just so scared because they're all tied to each other. So I was like, don't you dare go out and fight until this Fatal Bonds is finally worn off. And now Fogged already initiated out on Biz. And Fogged loses his life. He tried to get one last shock off there, but he was completely out of mana. And any match will take his life. But at the same time, Dignitas will take the tier 2 tower in the bottom, tier 2 tower in the mid. And then they'll want to rotate up towards the top lane. Last out of tower of RoxKiss remaining up there. What's our overall advantage? So, decently high. I get a big flat liner there. I don't think it's normally that flat, but I think the pause screws with it a little bit. So Biz, back to farming, but he's got Battle Fury and Treads, and he can't enter his own jungle. Well, he can. Now he, in fact, is going to retreat. But the last push from Dignitas should be coming through that top. Their goal, their objective right now, especially now the universe has a mech, is to basically never let the creep wave on the top pass this line. It must always be that direction. Push out the tier 2 tower, and then never allow RoxKiss to move past this line. They control this camp, and this camp, and they'll instantly see who's going to be here by putting up an observer ward up on the top. Another one just down here, or a little bit more aggressively, you can throw it up a little bit deeper in the lane. Yeah, you knew that was coming. So, I try and draw a circle, it looks more like a heart. But that's going to be the strat for Dignitas. They can try and push to the bottom. The bear's just sitting down here. It's not doing much more than that. But yes, that's what we're looking at. So we're looking at a Maelstrom coming off from Dree. He's got no other option. And there's a Maelstrom up here on Nature's Prophet too. So he's looking to push and farm, kind of build. Prophet will take care of the mid as well as the bottom. That's Prophet's little goal. Keep them pushed out. And let the rest of his team be aggressive on the other lanes. Is he mag skewer? Yeah, he's running away on the top. Well, Ow, he's taking care of an ancient stack. Building into that BKB of his. They still gotta try and lock down the control over this jungle. The more time they're giving Biz, the more farm he's getting. He'll have a Yasha soon. Now if that mana star pops up, pretty sure it dispels the fatal bonds.
Double damage.
I'll keep my eye a little bit closer for that once he gets there. But Dignitas, I really don't want to stand back too far. If they let this anti-mage farm up, then they can may as well call this game GG. In comes Universe, trying to force the blink away, and he is inside the tree lane. He can try and TP if he wants to. One blink in one more second, but the control is there. Fatal Bond's time to the creep wave. And he's going down a long way. There's a rocket on his tail. The further he runs, that rocket won't disjoint. That rocket will not disjoint. And depending on his timing for the TP, is he going to blink again? Yeah, he blinks again. This rocket's going to get very, very fast. It gains movement speed the longer it chases. Biz? Alright, he'll take the hit. Joins the rest of his teammates here in the mid, then jumps in. There's a double TP with a fortification up, and Warlock with Zoldman. They just skewer back out again. The Fatal Bonds, it connected the Venomancer and the Enchantress, and the Enchantress keeps healing up, and the Venomancer keeps losing his life from it, and then the fact back in again. And then jump up. Fog found solo. Hex. Now follow-up Shackle. Follow-up Shackle. Hold solo in position. There's not three heroes, so this Hellbear's not going to cancel this off. Sentry wards go down. They realize they're visible here. But it doesn't matter for them. Mag, while he does manage to escape himself out, T2 tower goes down, the Enchantress on the sideline, the anti-mage is licking his wounds back at base. And it's a key objective, the Dignitas. Surprisingly, they take last. But they take it without throwing out an ultimate. And I didn't realize that's an Agon Inceptor ultimate up on Aoi. Up on Sneaking. And then Prophet to join him. Surprisingly not split pushing. He wants to be there with the team. But he's got to keep his distance. Must keep his distance. Mass Serpent wants to go down. They want to get close enough to clean this off. But Fog, all he's got to do is just let off one quick Aether Shock. And he'll take care of that new creep wave. And the Bear's the one at the front lines for Dread. Fatal Bonds now ties the Bear, Dread, and Yol together. Rocket as well. Stun that Bear up. Ow, he keeps doing that damage. But Dread will be happy to tank that. A lot of Venomancer wards here. The new creep wave up as well. And Dignitas. This is when split pushing works better for them. Fog should be down there on that bottom lane. Popping ulti. Keep those creep waves pushed in. Right now, Biz feels the rest of his team can take care of that base. So he comes out, he farms up the mid, he pushes it out, he'll look for a tier 1 tower. And here we go again. Aoi, Entangle, up on that high ground. They've got to be careful about this. Couple of imps from Yol. Aoi loses a little bit of life, mech charge from the Darkseer. Brings him back up again. But in the meantime, as I was saying, Biz, he's going to take this tier 1 tower. Prophet will bounce, but it's already too late. Now Aoi, he's the man to TP in. He wants Biz. Again, the rocket will chase. The support's rotating down from the rest of Dignitas. They want to catch him out halfway up. And Prophet's the man to TP in, but he TP'd the wrong way. Biz finally tanks the hit. No one's getting close enough. Maybe Fox. He gets the Hex. You can see the blades go for the quick blink and then the Shackle. They pick off the anti-mage. And they're in the neighborhood for Roshan, so they're going to take him. Prophet will TP back to base. He needs his mana back again. So they get a kill on the big man. He has cash to buy back. Oh, no, he doesn't. He's short by 5 gold. But Dignitas, they're really not sure about this. There's trees coming in. There's the buyback. He buys back as fast as he possibly can. Jaro now has a BKB, but the courier's going to get back to base and then fly back out again. Anyway, what are you doing, man? He gets the cash to buy back and he heads down towards the bottom lane of farm. He wants the tier 1 tower. At the cost of Roshan, he's going to look for the tier 1 tower. Last time this happened, he gave away his life. Is he going to get the last hit? He's waiting for the catapult to hit. Now the last hit. Gets back most of the gold, which he lost. Of course, that came through the buyback. But now BKB and Aegis Immortal now up on Gyro. Can be the push to end all pushes. But Nature's Prophet's still got to keep up with that split push, or else this keeps happening. Biz, he may not have the best net worth in the game, but with some help from Solo, if he gets a good RP off, and then just mana burns everything else out, they will find one, possibly two kills. They're looking for one kill on the bottom lane. Solo's, yeah, he's forced a TP back. Animage also has a TP scroll, but he'll keep the pressure on. All Ross kids have to do is just hold him at bay. Don't let them up on the high ground. Or if they do, force out the ultimate from Warlock. In the meantime, Biz plays around the bottom lane. Prophet tries to hold the creep wave out. Prophet could almost lose his life if he's not careful. Yeah, and they delay it. They actually delay it. It might be 1-0 to Dignitas, but Roskis, they're bunkering in, and there goes Yolt. Might just show you the frustration level that Sneaking is currently feeling. He wants to throw that ulti down. Do they use it to get to the high ground? No, they use it to kill an Enchantress on the top lane. It's still their advantage, but they cannot finish. They run the risk of giving a team fight to Roskis. And give a team fight to Roskis while Biz is still farming up. And you find yourself losing the entire battle. And now, oh, death. Death. AM ulti. Sprouts up, but already Biz takes it. So it's a solo kill coming the way of the Animage now. And he cleans up the entire army of Treants. And then the creep wave. And we'll just keep pushing on this bottom lane. This is actually Roskis. Man. The way I'm seeing this in my mind right now is actually with Roskis winning. They're still going to push out and get through two tier 2 towers, but depending on the decisions of Dignitas, they could be losing this game in like the next 10 minutes. Not through Raxing. But the next team fight could happen in the next 10 minutes if they get impatient. Which I wouldn't be surprised if they do. Like, look at Warlock. He's walking around with 3.3k gold. He wants to buy something new and different for his kids. Shadow Shaman phase boot so we can get in range enough. That's what he was using before when they were chasing down the Animage. And it ran right through the rest of his teammates so he could catch up. And then phase boots up on Gyro, 2k gold. He won Solo's life. And he'll come up for it. Problem is he can't use cooldown to kill off Solo because the second he does, this will help out. Prophet Alderman knows he's visible. There's a skewer away. Goes straight through the sprout. Maelstrom will still hit, but it's an escape mechanism. They cannot control him. He'll always jump back out again. So in the meantime, he got more farm up to 1,400 gold now up on him. Maybe one day he'll finish a magic wand. And what did Animage just get? So full mana is now completed. I hate to say that Dignitas is running out of time. Net worth is almost higher on the Animage than it is the Gyro. And this won't stop. Warlock still no ultimate. 16 seconds and also a long way away from the engagement. He's down here on the bottom lane. It's another hero just walking around by Dignitas that is not ready to fight. And it's too late. Animage again with a TP scroll. So all they gotta do is let the defense there. Thread keeps the bear on the front lines. The wall of wards is up. Dignitas cannot push in. Now the TP is down towards the bottom lane. They want the kill on this Animage. The only way they're really gonna get it is if that side of the vice is finished up on Nature's Prophet. And he's still another, what, 2,900 gold away from it. And Biz is just taking all their farm from the jungle. Doesn't matter if Fog wants to phase boots up here. He's not going to catch him in time. Biz is taking their resources. He's taking their map control. And Dignitas aren't finding a way around it. Now Dredd's even confident enough to walk outside of his own base. So is Solo. Yol might finally get herself another creep friend. Now he wants a kill up here on the top lane. He has not had a chance. Since he bought this BKB, he has not had a single chance where it was viable to use it. And now it's Warlock in the bottom lane. Animage to a point can still solo him. Get in there, start the attack, pop the mana style. It's the reason why we're seeing Warlock now with building into an Orchid. Oh no, that's Refresher. He's building Refresher. And that is just crazy. We're going to have four Rock Golems on the ground. That's one way to push in. That's a double AoE stun as well. And Ferox kids get caught in that, but then they're not, because they don't want to be. They hold back, they leave the bear on the front lines, it's Venom and supports. How are Dignitas supposed to get that big ultimate off? It's not as though you got a Blink Dagger up on Warlock to get it in a good position. Their only option is to force up into the high ground, and that's going to come on the back of a Gyro, who now, he's getting better damage. Demon Edge is up for him. But they need that Scythe of Vice. They desperately need that Scythe of Vice. Now there's your Refresher Orb, so that is going to be Refresher, now done for Warlock. Well, actually no, he's just a little bit short. One more farm on this bottom lane, he might have it, but there's too many Animages down here. Is he Fatal Bond or try it? Yeah, he'll Fatal Bond. Biz is connected to that. He's still got a couple of AM illusions to get through at the same time. Owie getting hunted up on the top lane. Have they got Gem up? Nope, they got Sentries. Biz still taking damage, and that's all the way from the bottom lane. So these creeps get killed off, Biz takes a little bit of extra damage. But he won't care. Then with that creep wave going down, yep, there's Refresher. Now fully done. So we see the 10,000 experience and about 12, just over K gold advantage. And now we're on the back of that, almost at the point of having the BKB. Not the BKB, the Monkey King bar. So also if he wants to spend all of his cash, or if he just says, screw it, how long till Roshan's up? Well, so 3 minutes time and then Roshan will respawn. So look for that. 30 minutes and 30 seconds and Roshan should be back up again. And now Biz. He's feeling the time to go down. It's like, oh, Ancient's gone. Someone's going to be around here somewhere. Oh, middle lane. That's the place to be. But they've also got to be wary of sneaking. See him move himself back. It's that little bit further. He cannot, however, afford to take any kind of, like major damage from the Animage, because once he does, he's going to lose so much mana. Mana burn of 64 per hit. And he needs 300 for each ultimate, and then 375 for the Refresher Orb. He's basically out by that point. He'll get one Fatal Bonds off, maybe two. He's got 15 one charges and one bottle charge. It's not a very high mana pool. It lets him get his combo, but if Animage gets a couple of hits, he won't get the combo. And be heavily reliant on those 15 swan charges. But in we go. Mass Serpent wards are down. Shockwave as well. Want to kill off the creep wave. The bear's the only thing in the front lines. There goes the tier 3 tower. Now Dignitas. They finally going to force this. Fortification is out. Nanny Mage buys a BKB. He bought out for this. He bought that BKB for this. He has nothing left. Mag will deny the top tower. The Mass Serpent wards are gone. Dignitas will not want to give this up. But now with the BKB up on the Nanny Mage, it's almost like Rockskiss. They want to fight. They realize the Animage is the only way they're going to carry this game through. They've got to protect him. Owie in the front lines. Fortification's gone. BKB is up. Look at that life just disappear from the Venomancer. He's already dead. Now they're going to focus onto the bear as well as the Rax at the same time. Hex is up and in comes Animage. Warlock, first ultimate. Refresher Orb, second ultimate. While the wall is already up too. Biz losing a lot of life. Mag forced to buy back. Dread resummoning his bear a little bit further back, and now there's just so many rock golems on the field. They will just melt through the buildings and rotate in towards the middle lane. It was a perfect Darkseer wall, in fact. And then they got their ulti combos right. They just had to get themselves up to that high ground, and the tier 3 tower stopping it the entire time. And Yol, he wants the gyro. With the entangle, they might have a chance for it, but look at that Monkey King bar damage. Vac back out again. Blink down by Biz. He's looking for an opening solo. Skewers back all of the golems, but then they just start attacking on both him as well as on Biz. And Venomance doesn't want to be part of this, and then he is part of this. Destroyed off, sneaking, and GG is the call out by Dread. This game is over. And RoxKiss will be pushed down to the lower bracket. And they'll face up against Mousesports to see who will remain in the competition. Well, Dignitas, they have managed to set themselves a date. They have a date. And that's in the winner's bracket semi-final, where they'll be facing up against Team Empire. Should be an interesting battle. Nicely done, Biz. Nicely done. goes down in style. Venom answer, however, not so much style. One hit from Maui will take him. Now, yep, boom. Just Darkskin, which got the kill at the end of the day from that. Yeah, but that's going to be it for our day, guys. Remember, rest up. We'll be back here in about 8 hours' time. In 8 hours' time, we'll be doing the wonderful competition that is Tech Labs. We'll be starting at 7:15, so the live stream probably going to be coming up about 7 o'clock. If you want to stick around, if you miss any of the matches from today, they'll be restreamed out in about probably 10 minutes. The restream will normally start about 5 minutes after the broadcast ends. So stay tuned around for that one if you want to watch. Watch the American teams from Tinit. I say American teams. Team Liquid played. Liquid played early tonight up against Fnatic. And Dignitas up against Roxas. Yeah, American per game. Everything will be installed for you then. Or if you want, check out the VODs. I'll also start uploading them. They're normally available about an hour to an hour and a half at the end of the last match of the day. And most of that time is just for YouTube processing. Ray! There's your RP solo. And there's the side device. Nice damage! Fighting to the last moment there, Biz. Fighting to the very, very last moment. Then buybacks, they want this kill. Two hits from Nature's Prophet would have got it. Universal hunts him. And then, oh, he backs him and saves him from the rock. But the rocks are down inside the well. Biz goes with a smile on his dial. But that'll be the end. That'll be it. So I'll see you all again tomorrow morning at 7 o'clock. 9 o'clock if you're in Russia, 8 o'clock in Ukraine, I believe it is. And depending on where you are around the world, just check out joinDOTA for the countdown time and you'll find it. We're doing our first match tomorrow, which will be IC Cup, going up against Virtus Pro, best of one matchup, and then Na'Vi go up against Team Empire. That is the upper bracket semifinals. And then we go through the rest of it. The schedule will be published a little bit later on. Actually, I think most of the schedule is there for what's going on. But if you want to keep up to date with it, just tune in to the live stream. I'll let you know everything. All right, guys. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you tomorrow.